In this video, I'm going to talk about Photoshop Actions, what they are, how to create them, and use them on your editing workflow. Hello, photographer. Welcome back to my channel. For the ones who doesn't know me yet, my name is Sylvia. I'm a specialist in the magazine style of maternity photography. In this channel, I talk about photography editing techniques to help you make more money with your photos. Now, let's get into the video. Photoshop Actions is something really important, and if you're a photographer that wants to make money with photography and have a business, you need to know about the actions. What actions are is pretty much a button with a pre-record steps of actions that you take in Photoshop. So instead of you doing the same steps over and over again for each photo that you're going to be retouching, you can just click the action button in Photoshop will create all the steps for you. So let's say, for example, that I want to do some skin retouch in this photo. Every photo that I take, I go through the process of doing skin retouch. And the way that I do my skin retouch is with the frequent separation. So I need to create a new layer. I need to add some effects to the layer. I group all of them. I like to organize the layer. And then I start actually retouching the photo. So these previous steps that I need to take before I actually retouch the photo are steps that I need to take for every of my photo. So what I do is create an action that I can just click the button and Photoshop will do all these steps for me. And why is this so important? Well, first, because it's annoying for you to do this over and over again in every photo that you're going to be working. And when you have actions already created and saved, this will save you tons of time in your post-production. And since you are a professional photographer and you want to make money, you need to save your time so you can have more time to actually do other things for your business or even to live your life, you know, to do other things, because retouching a photo can take a long time. But when you know small things, small details, like using Photoshop Actions tool, this is gonna help you a lot in your retouching working flow process. Now, let's see how we can actually create the action. So I already have my action here, is this triangle, but if you do not have your action visible anywhere, you can just click Windows and go to Actions. And when you click this, it's gonna open exactly what I already have here, is this triangle here. So this is what's going to open. Yours might look a little bit different than mine. Yours might look a little bit like this. So there are two ways that you can visualize action. One is just like this, and the other way is seen as a button. So it is the button mode. And for you to change and switch the mode, you just need to click in these lines here, and you click in the button mode. The button mode is like this one where you can see colors, and the other way is like this, and it's where you're gonna be able to actually create your action. When you're seeing the action property tab here as the button mode, you cannot create the action. So this is just an easier way for you to visualize the actions with colors, so it helps you to be faster when you're looking for an action. But again, for you to create the action, create the steps and record it, you need to be seeing your action like this. So let's see how we can use this. Let me put this back. Okay, so for us to create an action, we need to start recording everything that we are going to do in Photoshop. Let's say that I wanna do some dodge and burn using curves. So for me to create a dodge and burn, I need to go to filter here and I create the curves layer. This is going to be my dodge. I'm gonna duplicate this layer. So Command J, I'm gonna type it burn. So the dodge, I'm gonna go a little bit up with my lighting and I'm gonna change the blending mode to luminosity. And for the burn, I'm gonna go lower with my curves. I'm gonna change the blending mode to luminosity. Now I'm gonna invert the mask. So I'm gonna click the mask and press Command I, and then press Command I for the dodge. I like to put both of them in a folder. So I select the both layers. I click Command G, and now I have a folder, and I like to name this Dodge and Burn. Now I'm gonna open the folder, and I'm gonna have both layers here ready for me to start to use the Dodge and Burn technique. So this is pretty much how you create the Dodge and Burn technique using curves. But you don't want to be doing this for every photo. That's why we're going to create an action. So for us to create an action, what we're going to do is to click here. We are going to record every step that I've just taken right now to create the technique, the Dodge and Burn technique with curves. So I'm going to name here. You are going to choose the name of the action that makes sense for you. So for example, Dodge and Burn. I'm gonna say curves, so I know that I'm talking about the Dodge and Burn with curves. I can choose a color. Remember that when we go to the button mode, we have some colors there. So that's where I can choose the colors here. So let's just say red. You can add some keyboard shortcut. I'm not gonna add anything. And that's it. I'm gonna hit record. Let me just close a few actions here so it's easier for us to see. So it is right here, Dodge and Burn, and you can see that it's recording because it has this red button right here, meaning that it's starting to record. So now everything that I do here, Photoshop will start recording every step. So let's go to filter, let's create curves. I'm gonna duplicate the curve, so Command J. One is gonna be the Dodge, the other one's gonna be Burn. I'm gonna invert the masks. I'm gonna go up with my curve here in Dodge. I'm gonna go down with my curve here in Burn. I'm gonna change the blending mode to luminosity for both layers. I'm gonna select both layers and press Command G to put in a folder. I'm gonna name it Dodge and Burn. Oops, here. I am gonna open the folder and I'm gonna select in the Dodge, and also I'm gonna choose my brush. And now that I have done everything, let me just close this property really quick. I'm gonna click here on the stop button, and now Photoshop is not recording anything anymore. So I can create many other things and it's not gonna be recorded in here. Let me just delete this. So now we have created our action, Dodge and Burn curves. Let me rename this. To rename it, you can just double click on the name, because I think I might have this this name already. So Dodge and Burn curves 2 is our action right now. So now I can go here on the lines and click in the button mode. And we created right here, Dodge and Burn curves number 2. So I'm gonna delete what we have created, and now I'm gonna press just this button, and Photoshop would do all of the steps that we have just done it. Photoshop would do it for me in less than a second. Right there. So it's ready. Even the brush that I selected right here, Photoshop already got the brush for me. I'm gonna show you again. I'm gonna delete this action. I'm gonna have like another tool selected, and I'm gonna click Dodge and Burn. So my brush was also selected because I selected the brush. So this is something that will save you a lot of time. And you can create actions for everything. So for example, I have for skin retouch, I have for Dodge and Burn, different Dodge and Burns, I have for yellow teeth, I have to put add grain in my photo, sharpen my photos, I have for luminosities, I have for color grading. So you can create many, many things that if you're doing in every photo, taking the same steps, something that is the same in every photo, just create an action for it, because it's gonna save you a lot of time. Now you know what actions can do for you in your business and how to create them. Click the like button if that was helpful for you. If you want to know other ways to improve your skills to make more money with photos, check out my latest video here on the screen. Also, subscribe to my channel. I post new videos every week. For now, this is everything. Until next time.